Are you looking to smash your opponents at the next standard event, poison your foes in Pauper, or empty libraries in Eternal formats? No matter what way you prefer to vanquish the foul, you'll find the tools you need at channelfireball.com. We've got great prices on singles, boosters, sealed boxes, sleeves, and anything else you need to take home the win at your next PTQ or at your kitchen table. Don't get lost in a labyrinth of online shopping. Just try channelfireball.com.
Welcome to another Holiday Cube Draft here on Magic Online, where I've got some options here. I've got Oath of Druids, which is not a bad first pick. Demonic Tutor, which I think is very good. Basalt Monolith, which is the worst of the monoliths, much worse than Grim. And that's basically all the cards I would consider first picking. I'm going to take Demonic Tutor, though. Demonic Tutor is just so good, and it works in almost every deck. Oath I actually like a lot, too, but and it's even better when you first pick it, but I think just taking a tutor means that almost no matter which direction you go, you can end up doing some good stuff. Ooh, speaking of good stuff, Mana Vault's very good. I like Compulsive Research, but I like Mana Vault more. I also like Kozilek once you have a channel. Those are the cards I'd be looking at here. I don't mind Lotus Cobra in normal cubes, but in Powered Cube, I think you can do better. But starting with Demonic Tutor, Mana Vault is a good place to go. This isn't the best vault, though. Time Vault is, of course, the best vault and the best card in the cube. Alright, what do we have to follow it up? Actually, it's probably going to be Dimir's Signet. I already have a black card. Black-blue Signet is one of the better Signets, and the Signets are really, really good. I don't need Bloodstained Mire yet, though. I would like that card. Goblemolder's cool, but that's the kind of card I want to take a little bit later. Don't mind Regrowth, but again, Signet is what it is. I like Lodestone Golem a decent amount, but not enough to take a Signet over, or pass it for a Signet. Oh, now I can take Revelation, take Jace. Take a bad fetch land. Bad isn't it? Doesn't have blue or black, which are colors that I'm looking at. Could take Armageddon, though. I don't think this is looking quite like the deck that wants Geddon. I don't know. It's tough. It's like Revelation is decent. Jace is decent. Not much else I'm really considering. I don't think Arid Mesa. I mean, if I already had like a Volcanic Island, Arid Mesa would be a lot more appealing, but I don't. And this could easily be the artifact-based deck, where actually I do like Rev. The Jace, I have a blue-black Signet, Demonic Tutor. Yeah, I'm going to take Jace. The Wildfire blue-black-red artifact deck is also a really good one. Ooh, now there's a Bargain and a Gruul Signet. Though with Mana Vault and Demonic Tutor, Bargain's looking pretty good. I don't mind Everflowing Chalice, but this card seems to go really late for some reason. Either way, there's also Imperial Seal. Now I'm going to take the Bargain. I think I like Bargain more than Imperial Seal here. That's close, though, because Imperial Seal could mean I could do a different combo deck, but Bargain helps me make sure that this is the deck that has cards to tutor for, whereas taking a bunch of tutors and hoping to get cards like Bargain later might not work out as well. Alright, now I can take Winter Orb, which does go in the artifact plan, but I'm not really there. I could take Nicole Bolas, actually is reasonable here, given that I have Mana Vault and I'm going to play Blue Black. There's also Memory Lapse, though. I've been very impressed with Memory Lapse. I think actually Memory Lapse is the card, though Nicole Bolas is so sweet. No, I'm going to take Memory Lapse. I want to win this draft, and I think winning the draft is more likely to happen if I take Memory Lapse here than if I take Nicole Bolas. Now I can take Wildfire. That's one of the cards that is important in the deck with a bunch of artifact mana and signets. Or I could take Pentad Prism, which looks like it's going to be decent also. I think I'm just going to go with the Prism here. It's not as good as a Signet generally. Probably better than like a green-white Signet in this deck, but it's not as good as like a black-red or a blue-black or a red-blue Signet. Also, I'm assuming I'm playing red, but that's not necessarily even the case. Alright, that's a late Force of Will, and I actually think it might be good in this deck. I have a couple blue cards already. Don't need Electrolyze or Mishra's Factory. Things are looking interesting. This could be a blue-black control deck, too. I mean, Bargain, obviously, is a combo card, but I'm actually drafting a decent, potentially interactive deck with Memory Lapse, Force of Will. Even Jace is a little bit interactive. That's a late Ravages of War, and I like it better than Armageddon this cube because the picture is so much better, but I'm just going to take Sheevan Reef. Sheevan Reef, I think, is a good card to have. Ooh, Sulphurous Springs. Don't like Firebolt that much, but I do like having Sheevan Reef and Sulphurous Springs in case I do want to go into red. Well, I don't want to play against Nether Void. I could have Disfigure as a sideboard card, or I could just take Goblin Welder, even though I'm not necessarily going to play it at this point. But the potential for this card to be good is definitely there. So I think I'm going to start by doing that. We've got a decent shot at having cards that care about that. Alright, I guess I'll take Living Death. Don't like any of these cards, but it's a thing. Terminate is at least potential. Don't really like Grixis control. Would rather be, again, proactive. I think this cube really rewards you for doing broken proactive things. Playing like the Wildfire artifact mana deck is one. Playing an artifact synergy deck with Goblinmolder is another. And there's often, you know, overlap. Also, just playing a combo deck with Bargain and DT. I guess I'll take... actually take Burst Lightning. It's actually a sideboard card. This deck could legitimately be a Grixis control deck. It's got Burst Lightning, Terminate some Grixis lands. There's a possibility to have that, but I would rather not be there if I can avoid it. Good, this can help me avoid it. I'll take a Time Twister now. Still need fast mana. You know, gonna need a lot more than what I have, but Time Twister is a very powerful card. My appreciation for this card has increased in this queue. Ooh, got some options here, but I think it's going to be Library of Alexandria. This card is pretty nice. And even though I like to learn Academy, first of all, there's a chance at wheels. Second of all, I'm not really there yet on Academy, whereas Library of Alexandria is very, very strong. Nothing else here I would even consider. Ooh, I like Rakdos Signet. Going to be hard-pressed to pass that one. Empty Warren's cool. I don't have a win condition yet, but I think that's one of the weaker win conditions, and I don't need to be Storm. I could take Rakdos Signet and, again, draft a pretty sweet deck. I don't mind Watery Grave either, but Signets are more important than lands. Alright, what do we got here? I've already passed on Wildfire, so if I don't take Burning of Xinyi here... I mean, I might wheel it, but the other one didn't wheel. And so I might be done with Wildfires if I don't take that. Could take Gristlebrand. I don't have a Show and Tell or anything. It's a powerful card, though. Could also take Sundering Titan. It's much more castable, especially with cards like Mana Vault. Could take Azorius Signet. And I could take Scrollrack. Scrollrack's an interesting card, too. I like it when you're going off. It lets you see tons of new cards. It's actually really close. This taking Sundering Titan also makes Tinker better. I think I'm just going to take Sundering Titan. I don't know. That pick could be very, very wrong. But I think Scrollrack is a good shot of wheeling. People don't seem to like that card. And Azorius Signet doesn't seem quite as important. But it could be Azorius Signet is better than Sundering Titan here. That I'm not sure about. All right. This pack is a lot less exciting. I'm not going to play Bitter Blossom. I'm not Ice Crown Sectoring up my memory lapse. Guess I could take Tropical Island. That is... very lame, but I don't think I want Buried Alive either. I've not been super happy with that card, though. I guess I have Living Death. I could try to set up Buried Alive, Living Death combo deck. You know, Buried Alive might wheel, and dual lands are good. I mean, this way, even if I pick up, like, a Verdant Catacombs, it gets blue and black mana now. Alright, what do we got? Ooh, the Abyss is kind of nice, actually, but I think I'd rather just take Polluted Delta. Polluted Delta's awesome. Can't go wrong taking on-color fetch lands, double on-color fetch lands, especially. Necro I don't like that much, whereas Bargain is awesome, just because... being able to use it the turn you play it is just so important. Ooh, well, I wish I could make a really good Bizarre Baghdad Cube deck. This is not the deck for it, for sure. I have no reanimation, very few targets. On the other hand, Orzhov's Signet is a card which I'm not going to be unhappy taking. So, and that makes me happier about the Sundering Titan pick, too. It's still a half on-color Signet, the other half, of course, being white, too, which is kind of funny compared to Azorius Signet. And now that I have three Signets and a Pentad Prism, I don't feel as bad about passing up on Signet for Titan. Ooh, I don't mind Forcebike. I like Thoughtseize. Smokestack I've tried to get to work and it never has. Actually, I think I'm just going to take Thoughtseize. I think there are matchups where that card is very, very good, even though I wouldn't always main deck it. Alright, Palancron has some infinite combos with like Heartbeat of Spring, but I actually think I'm going to take Necromancy. There's a decent shot that I can make a Reanimator deck out of this if I pick up like an Entomb and an Animate Dead in Pack 3, which is not unreasonable. I mean, it's not those aren't the sort of cards that everyone wants. I also have Goblinwalder, actually, to be fair. We should actually be keeping that one around. Because now that I have Sundering Titan, Goblinmolder gets a little more interesting, too. Alright, I don't like Gatekeeper. Archer's a decent sideboard card. I'm going to take Pestermite. There's a decent shot I can do something with that. And I don't really want Bayou, even though I do have Pluto Delta and Tropical Island already. I'm going to take Faithless Looting. That card's great with Goblinmolder. And even though I don't want to play against Spirit of the Labyrinth, I think having Faithless Looting is pretty sweet. Ooh, Scorak did wheel. So did Burning. Ooh, this is tough. You know, this... I was going to say, it doesn't look like a Burning of Xinyi deck, but I actually don't know this. Yeah, I'm going to take the Burning. I think the upside on that is higher than the upside on Scrollrack, even though Scrollrack is decent. Well, Buried Alive did come back, so I'll take that just in case. And sure, I'll take the Necro. I mean, you never know. Though this doesn't look as much like a combo deck, at least not a Storm combo deck. See, it's packs like this, which is why people say Magic Online has collation issues. Look, there's a Black Lotus, a Soaring, and a Time Vault all in the same pack. Oof. And I don't even know what to take. I haven't seen Key yet, or Tezzeret. Lotus is awesome, especially since I have Yawgmoth's Bargain and Demonic Tutor, but Demonic Tutor plus Time Vault... ugh. I don't actually know what to do here. I think I'm going to take the Time Vault. It's crazy, but if I can pick up a way to untap it, having DT Time Vault is just so, so much more powerful. I have a Pestermite, turns into a Time Walk, bam. And even though my second pick would have been Lotus. I think Lotus is better than Sol Ring, especially when I have like Bargain and Time Twister. All right, I'm going to take Consolation Prize Sol Ring. Worn Power Stone is good. I'm not going to take Reanimate there. Ooh, is it Signet? It's pretty great. I have Kiki Jiki because I have Pestermite, but Kiki Jiki might wheel, and I think Is It Signet is just so good that I've got to take it, and I don't really want to play tons of red mana, I don't think. I don't mind Strip Mine, but it's no Is It Signet. Can I just get a Voltaic Key? That's all I'm looking for. Part of my logic with taking Time Vault over Lotus is also that even though I do have Bargain and Time Twister, this deck doesn't really have a combo finish, so having an actual win condition I think is more important. Of course, now there's Dark Ritual, which might actually be the pick here. Yeah, I think Dark Ritual Bargain and Dark Ritual Time Twister are both decent. Dark Ritual Sundering Titan. I don't need Lightning Greaves, though. It's kind of cute, though. I actually might play Lightning Greaves in this deck if I can wheel it, which it usually does. See, here we go. We've got Raul Zarek ready to step up and untap some Time Vaults. Yeah. That is what I am looking for. I would rather have Key. Voltaic Key is the card I would most want to see here, especially since I have Goblin Welder to get them back and all that nonsense, but well, I don't want to play against this. I will take Volcanic Island, though. That one seems good. Well, I do like Channel in this deck, but I don't think I'm going to try to support Double Green. I think I'd rather just take Duress, have another piece of Disruption. Lotus Bloom. Might still be the pick. I'm not playing any of these other cards, and I would suspend a Lotus Bloom on turn one. So I'm going to end up with just the Raul Zarek for Time Vault, but that's probably fine. Do I want a Vorrath Stronghold? Probably not. Young Pyromancer could be a card, though. I could see that working out. Given where I ended up, I'd much rather have Scroll Rack over Burning of Xinyi at this point. But what can you... All unplayables with a Chain Lightning. And at this point, I'm not even looking at playing much blue. Maybe I just play Time Twister and none of the other blue cards. That actually might be fine. Well, Raul Zarek, obviously. Ooh, Kiki Jiki. That actually makes... Ooh, I kind of like that now. Now that I'm cutting most of the blue, I can like cut Force of Will, Memory Lapse, Jace. I can play Kiki Jiki Pestermite. And because I'm going to be playing mostly red and black mana, have another combo plus Pestermite and Time Vault is a Time Walk, which it's not irrelevant to remember. So I'll take Huntmaster. Ooh, this is actually a tough pick. I think I actually just take Dreadbore here because I already have like Chain Lightning. Brain Maggot doesn't complement Thoughtseize and Duress all that well. All right, go to deck boot. All right, so what do we get? Count Library as a land. I mean, this is 24. Let's just go ahead and look at by mana cost. Let's look at my mana cost without a zero drop. Goblin Welder is definitely good. I do like the Pestermite Kiki Jiki combo, actually. Not sure about Burning yet. And I'm not sure that I don't want Memory Lapse. What fixing I've dealt? I have quite good fixing. Get out of here, Trop Gond. No one's talking to you. Delta, Sulphur Spring, Sheevan Reef, Volcanic Island, and then all the Signets like Dimir, Rakdos, and Is It, plus Pentad Prism, all these things. So don't mind that. I don't actually know if I want Bargain, though I think it's good enough with Demonic Tutor and Dark Ritual, Worn Power Stone. Don't actually know if I want Young Pyromancer either. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, this is not looking good. This card's decent. I think even though it kills Welder, Pestermite, Kiki, I think it's good enough as a Miser card. And just ramping it out with all these Signets and whatnot. Don't think Force of Will is good enough. Don't think Jace is good enough. I think Duress and Thoughtseize are just going to be better than Memory Lapse, so there's no reason to add those. And I don't think I want to play Burst or Chain Lightning, at least not in the main deck. Could also play Necromancy, but I don't think that's good enough either. Faithless Looting. Looting Necromancy is kind of cool. Because I can loot and then Necromancy up a Kiki Jiki. It's kind of interesting, actually. Might be better than Duress in the main deck. I like the Dreadbore well enough, so I'm going to keep that. And I like Time Twister. I think Time Twister is good enough here. I just have a couple different two-card combos that win me the game, so drawing seven cards and then ending the game seems good enough to me, especially with lots of fast mana. And if once Bloom comes in, Welder Lotus Bloom is really nice. So do I want Necromancy? That is the question. Necromancy out of Sundering Titan's not bad. So that's about it, though. It's basically got, like, two good targets, Sundering Titan and Kiki-Jiki, and I need Faithless Looting to make it work. Yeah, I'm just not going to do that. All right. And I don't think I'm playing Jace either. Because I think, let's see. I mean, I have basically two extra sources for each color off the Signets, plus an extra Black Signet and Orzhov Signet. Going to play the Library. I'm going to play these lands. And having those lands adds 1, 2, 3 blue. So I have 5 blue. 8 blue is definitely enough. If I can probably have more or less, rather, if I need to. And this is 1, 2, 3, 4 red. So 6 red. That's 11 red. That seems good. 1, 2 black. 4 black. This is 8 black right now. So I kind of want to go +1, -1, and bam, there we go. It's actually one too many blue, but I think, actually, you know, maybe I can get rid of one of the blue for, because right now I'm at 3, 6, 7, yeah, I can get rid of a blue for an extra red. Red seems pretty important, and I have Faithless Looting in red, so. All right, this deck seems like it's pretty busted, but we'll find out.